Hey, I'm Shoshana Chaim from the Plant Trainers Podcast, helping you improve your quality of life through nutrition and fitness. And today I want to talk to you about three ways to boost your mood. Now, mental health and mental illness is something that we do talk about on the podcast every couple of months. We've shared our personal stories and my personal struggles and triumphs with mental illness. We've talked about it from a nutritional point of view. We have talked about it from a lifestyle point of view. So if you wanted more information than what I'm about to talk to you today, you can go to planttrainers.com and you could search mental health in the little browser there, and you could find lots of great resources. But now what I want to do is I want to share with you three practical ways to boost your mood. So number one is to make sure that you're getting enough vitamin D. Vitamin D is fairly safe for most people. If it's something that you don't take already, you could think about talking to your healthcare practitioner about it before you begin. The Mayo Clinic recommends that people take around 600 IU a day, so that, you know, that's not so much for those winter months when we're not getting a lot of sunlight, or if you're not getting any of it inside of the food that you're eating anyway, because the foods are being supplemented with it. So what we often see is people taking 1,000 or 2,000 IU instead. A good way to gauge on whether or not you need it is in your next blood test, ask for vitamin D levels to be checked at that time, and then you'll get a sense of how high, how low it is, and how much you might need to supplement. Number two, according to studies done in 2015, there has been really great evidence showing that light therapy can help people with mood. So I have something over here, and it is called a SAD light. Now, this SAD light does not make you sad. SAD stands for seasonal affective disorder. So if you're someone who gets really down in those cloudy months when you can't get outside, and you know we have winter all around us, if you're one of those people, then you can consider one of these light therapies, and they are safe to use. You could follow the instructions, and for a lot of people, it does help. The third thing that you can try is doing something that you enjoy. There's been lots of studies showing that people who are part of communities or take part in hobbies, then their moods are lifted up. So some of you might have hobbies that you haven't taken part in a long time. When we work with our clients, we often have people come to us because of what I've shared, who have some mental health issues or mental illness. So we look at the whole person. So we've seen people get back into painting, get back into woodworking, get back into sports, doing something that they love, cooking for the love of it, not for the need of it. And this has really helped boost their moods too. So think about some of the hobbies that you have that you might want to start including into your life again. If you want some more ideas on practical ways to boost your mood, you could go to planttrainers.com/288, or you could check it out on iTunes, Stitcher, wherever you listen to podcasts. Be sure to subscribe there. But also, if you check out 288, I give a little bit of an update on how my story has progressed in the last couple of years in terms of my mental health. And also, we talk about some ideas that we use on a daily basis. So Adam, my co-host, and I use on a daily basis or weekly basis to help make sure our moods are lifted and are doing really great. If you have any ideas that you use to help lift your mood, feel free to write it in the comments. See you all later on the Plant Trainers Podcast. Bye.